everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on a High Elf Chariot. We're going to go ahead and work on the gold here today, try and finish it up on this main body of the chariot. Already got the gold mixed up, and I am ready and raring to go. I'm just going to start up here, kind of like I did when I was base coating initially with the brown, and just work my way across the model. If you happen to hear something in the background, that is my heater going. It's a new day. Thought I'd get a little painting done prior to heading into work, and it is very chilly this morning. Not really sure why, but not sure if I... What's going on? Who knows? Doesn't matter. What does matter? I said I'm at the painting table before I go to work, which is a rarity. But I really wanted to work on this chariot here. I was really hoping to get it done last night, but I was quite tired, and it just didn't happen. So, I'm going to work on it now. Maybe we can get this main body of the chariot done. And then I'll save the rest of it for after work. Little down here, not much. Kind of in this area here. Okay. Alright, that looks pretty cool. I'll pick up a little bit more of this in my brush, and I'll start working on this one. This should go a little more quickly than the base coating and shading section. Usually highlighting goes more swiftly than that. So, we'll see though. Alright. And while I've got it turned this way, I'll just go ahead and jump over here to this side. And just paint my heart away here. Let's spin it so I can access that little bit inside. Normally I wouldn't spin the model quite this much. But, otherwise I know myself, I'll probably forget that little area. Hope everybody out there is having a wonderful day. My day just started, so hey, so far so good. Can't complain. It's going very well. Any day I can wake up early and get a little exercise in before I go to work, and even get in a little bit of painting before I go to work. Boy, that's a heck of a day right there. About getting the underside of this area over here, because it's not really going to get much light at all, if any. So we're good there. So now let's move to the top here, or the front, I guess I should say. And I'll just go ahead and touch here and kind of down the side just a little bit. Do this right there, and then we'll do the same thing over here. And we'll spin the model and add another little bit of gold right in this area, and then right up in here. Okay, I think that's pretty darn good. So we'll set that down. Let me rinse my brush out very quickly. And let's get the second highlight color. paint here so it flows more smoothly. Gets a little bit translucent, so it's not so stark of a transition. Alright. And let's just begin over here again. And I'll start here, I think, this time. Just focusing towards the top of these goal areas. Just those areas where the sun would hit it the most. Paint's a little bit thicker this time than it was last time, but not much. Not much at all. Still want some of that previous color to be able to show through to help the blend. Let's just go ahead and do these while we're here. Since all I'm really going to be getting is the top of them anyway, I may as well touch them, since I can see everything that I'm going to be painting. Alright, now I'll come around to the front of the chariot and start working on it. Actually, I think I'm going to touch just a little bit on the sides of these things here, just to get a little color inside these areas as well. Not a whole lot. Maybe bring this highlight down just a little bit on the side. There we go. I have to be careful with this because the next highlight's going to be very, very bright, and I don't want it to be in the same intensity range as the ivory or the bone color. So I've got to kind of be careful that I don't leave a lot of space for that next color to on which I can put the next color. I really want most of this model to remain fairly dull in this gold, at least on this part of the model. Just a nice, deep, rich gold. Sort of a shiny brown, actually, more than anything. Alright. And then we'll just come in here like so. There we go. Alright, so we'll call that pretty good. I'm going to hit just that little area right there. Now, go ahead and rinse the brush out here. And let me get a little bit more of that gold so that I can then mix in another highlight colors. There we go. Alright, put this away. And let me get my highlight color out. That will be this one here. And we'll mix some of this in. And just see how she turns out. Oops. First of all, I have to retrieve my brush that I just threw into the floor. Okay. This is good, too. We got about 9 minutes in, so we should have time, theoretically anyway, to get up to that sunburst on the front of this chariot, which is kind of the area that I really wanted to get to last night, but never did make it. Exhausted. So, hopefully we'll make it this morning, and then I can feel like I accomplished what I wanted to do last night. And I won't have it hanging over my head all day while I'm at work. That'll be nice. Alright, so at this point, I'm really just touching those areas where the sun would be smacking down on this thing super hard. Super hot! Alright, there we go. Just little bits here and there. Leaving some of that last highlight color. Very nice, very nice. Alright, a little more highlight color. How about right up here? Right across this front beam. And then maybe pull that color down just a little bit. There we go. And then I'll do the same thing over here. Just like that. Okay. Alright. I think our gold is basically done. Let me pull that color down just a little bit across the front as well. Just to give it a little bit of... A little bit extra interest from the front of the miniature. Okay. Excuse me. So I'm just going to leave that there. Let me rinse my brush out and wipe it off and put a cap on it. I'll set that right there. And I'm going to switch out my water. So let's move that over here. And let's pull this in. Now, what do I need? I need a blue. What blue do I want to use? That's a completely different question. And it's one I'm not really sure about the answer of. I could use royal blue on the main body. It might have been a dark blue, though. I don't know. Let's make a decision. And, you know what? We'll just go with whatever we come up with. And let's go with dark blue. Why not? Alright, so I'm going to take a little of this. Alright, and we're going to come over here onto the palette and put some of this down. Okay. And I'm going to mix in just a little bit of black into this, I think. Just a tiny... Actually, you know what? I don't need to do that. I don't need to mix in any black. I believe that it's dark enough as it is. Because for the most part, we're going to be doing some edge highlighting. And with edge highlighting, I don't really need a very dark base coat. I just need some good contrast for my highlight colors. So, let's deal with it in its current state. No need to make it darker. And let's just begin. Let's begin down here, because this is going to be the messiest one. Okay, that's pretty good. And all I'm going to do is just kind of gently start drawing in these little sunburst things. And what I'll do is I'll kind of focus on the edges. Make it real easy. And then I'll come back in and actually color in the center. Very nice, very nice. Alright. Well, that right there just adds a whole new dimension to the miniature. I mean, that's really bright and really awesome looking. And it really helps to break up some of this ivory, or this bone color, whatever you want to call it. It's really more of a bone than it is an ivory. Excellent. A little more water in my brush here. Okay, probably... will end after I get this base coated, because I'm going to have to let this dry before I can put any sort of highlights on it. But this will give us a great starting place for the next video. Alright. Not really worried about touching that lion's head. That's one of the reasons I decided to do it after this, was because I figured with its position being kind of raised up like that right in front of everything, I figured, you know what, I'm probably going to get some paint onto it. And I was right. Just like always. Alright, let's see here. This is one of those areas of the model where you kind of wonder, you know what, maybe I should have painted this before I put it together. Urgh. The angle on this is absolutely horrible. Very, very bad. Okay, there we go. That helped. Wow, that was really rough. Okay, so now I should just be able to come in right here and poke a couple of times and finish out that section. There we are. Very nice. Alright, pick up a little bit more paint. Actually, I need to put a little more right in here. There we go. And now we'll come in here and do this. Pick up some more water. Some very, very thick paint that I'm working with here, so I have to keep kind of going back and forth to my water. But that's okay. As long as in the end it all gets painted, that's all that matters. All right. Whoops. Yep, see, there, got a little paint on that ivory. Don't know if you can see it. Yep, there you can. Right there. Right on the chariot. So I'll just remix my bone color. And come back in and clean that sucker up. But I'm not going to do it until we get everything else painted. Because I'm betting we're going to end up doing that more than once. Okay, that's kind of neat, I think, how the little sunburst actually goes into the mouth of the lion right there. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me move my fingers out of the way, get rid of some of the light, and you can probably see it there. All right, there we go. So, right there, my goodness, that does a wonderful job of, well, knocking a brush over. That does a wonderful job of kind of breaking up some of that color and really bringing a whole new dimension to the miniature. But for right now, I think we'll call it a video. And we'll come in next time, we'll highlight the little sunburst, and then we'll probably end up painting the lion. And then this central gold piece right up here that's, you know, being blocked by the oak. But up here that I did not do the previous time because I figured I'd probably be hitting it with the blue, even though I didn't. Yeah, we'll come in, we'll paint those two areas of gold, and get the edge highlights on the blue, and then start making up our way towards the front of the miniature, and get all this gold painted up here. But for right now, we'll call it a day. So I want to thank you guys for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, thank you for watching. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.